Today we shall learn about Nernst potential and Goldman-Hodgkin-Katz equation, right? Now we know that at rest a potential difference exists across the cell membrane of all the cells in the body. Okay, that is called as resting membrane potential, right? Nernst potential is that membrane potential across the cell membrane at which the concentration gradient for a particular ion is equal to the electrical gradient for that particular ion, but in opposite direction. Okay, so the concentration, let us say concentration gradient for this particular ion X is towards outside. Okay, the electrical gradient is towards inside. Okay, their concentration gradient is equal to electrical gradient, but they are in opposite direction to each other. Okay, so this is called as Nernst potential or equilibrium potential. Therefore, at Nernst potential, the net movement of a particular ion would be zero. Okay, because the concentration gradient and the electrical gradient are opposite in direction and equal in magnitude, they cancel each other out. So the net movement of the particular ion from one side to another side is zero. Okay. Nernst potential is calculated using the equation, Nernst equation. Okay. In Nernst equation, we calculate the electromotive force by the formula EMF is equal to plus or minus 61 log of concentration of a substance inside by concentration of that particular substance outside. Okay. This is the formula. This is the formula for calculating the Nernst potential for a particular ion. Okay. So here this positive ion, or rather the positive sign, is used whenever the diffusing ion is a negative ion. Okay. This negative sign is used whenever the diffusing ion is a positive ion. Okay. And while using this equation, it is assumed that the potential outside the cell, that is in the ECF, is considered to be zero. Okay. And the calculated Nernst potential is the potential for the particular ion inside the cell. Okay. Understand? Right. Now let us see an example to understand Nernst potential. Right. Let us take sodium as an example. The concentration of sodium ion in ECF is 142 milliequivalents per liter. Right. The same in ICF is 14 milliequivalents per liter. While calculating the Nernst potential for sodium, we use negative sign because this is a positive ion, minus 61 log of concentration inside is 14 by concentration outside is 142, so it is roughly minus 61 log of 1 by 10. Okay, so in logarithm, when we bring the numerator to the denominator upside down, then the negative sign becomes positive sign. Okay, so plus 61 log of 10, right? So log of 10 is 1, so the Nernst potential is plus 61 millivolts. This is the Nernst potential for sodium inside the cell membrane, right? So I hope you all understood Nernst potential or equilibrium potential. Now let's move on to Goldman-Hodgkin-Katz equation. The Nernst equation is used to calculate the membrane potential inside the cell membrane when we assume that the cell membrane is permeable to only one ion, right? But that is not the case in our body. Okay, our cell membrane is permeable to several ions like sodium, potassium, chloride, so forth, right? So in this case, what do we do? Okay, In this case, we use an equation called as Goldman equation or Goldman-Hodgkin-Cox equation to calculate the membrane potential inside the cell membrane, right? Now, you know, when the cell membrane is permeable to several ions, okay, membrane potential inside the cell membrane is dependent on three factors. Okay, one, polarity or charge on the ion. Two, permeability of the cell membrane to a particular ion. Three, concentration of the ion on both sides of the cell membrane. Okay, so these are the three factors on which the membrane potential inside the cell membrane depends, right? So Goldman-Hodgkin-Cox equation, right? So since our cell membranes inside our body are permeable to several ions, okay, we use the Goldman equation to calculate the membrane potential inside the cell. So that is given by the formula EMF is equal to minus 61 log of concentration of sodium inside into permeability of sodium plus concentration of potassium inside into permeability of potassium plus concentration of chloride outside into permeability for chloride divided by concentration of sodium outside into permeability of sodium plus concentration of potassium outside into permeability of potassium plus concentration of chloride inside into permeability of chloride. Okay, this is the equation, Goldman equation, which is used to calculate the membrane potential inside our cell membranes. Okay, when we use all the values for sodium, potassium and chloride, we get the value minus 86 millivolts. Okay, so the contribution by sodium, potassium and chloride, all three together, is equal to minus 86 millivolts. Here the chloride you can literally leave it, because the permeability of chloride is very minimal. Okay, so the contribution by the chloride is next to nothing. Therefore sodium and potassium are the two major ions which contribute to the membrane potential inside the cell membrane, right? Normally. So to summarize, Nernst equation is the equation which is used to calculate the membrane potential inside the cell membrane when it is assumed to be permeable to only one ion, right? And Goldman-Hodgkin-Cox equation, or simply called Goldman equation, is used to calculate the membrane potential inside the cell membrane when the cell membrane is assumed to be permeable to several ions. Okay, that is the case in our body. Okay, so this is what we understand by Nernst equation and Goldman equation.